Welcome back to a new video. If you are on the market to buy an electric car today and you don't know which one to buy, I tell you, you better wait a little bit more time because today I'm inside the new Hyundai Ioniq 5 and I will present you the multimedia system. I have to tell you, this car, it's incredible. I just drive it. I made a full review video. I made a test drive video. If you want to see it, click the subscribe button to see the notification when the video will come out. And I tell you, this car blew my mind. I want to buy one. Really, I want to buy one. And to be honest, I didn't test the full version of the car. I test the entry version of the car, the rear wheel drive, not the old wheel drive, and the smaller battery, and the fact that here inside we don't have the leather seats, or we don't have so many features that the other top version have, make me wonder how it looks, the full option, because this one here is just incredible. Anyway, let's go to the review, guys, and I will tell you that this version right here, the entry level version, come with a few changes that you will not find it on the all-wheel drive. I should say this one, it's missing some features that the all-wheel drive and the top version have it. So let's start, guys, by telling you the dashboard is just incredible. I mean, it looks gorgeous. The visibility outside, it's perfect. In the mirrors everywhere, it's just lovely. Also, you don't have a glove box right here. You have kind of a draw, and you have so much space here. It's just incredible. Look at this. It's just something new. You have so much space on the legs room right here. You have USB ports, plenty of space. Plenty of space here. USB port, you have a lot of space, guys. It's just incredible how spacious this car it is. Also, the car come with fabric material seat. This is the entry level, guys, by the way. But they are so, so comfortable. I drive the car before. They are incredible. Look at there in the back. So keep in mind, this is not the top version and it's still amazing. I mean, the way they create it, it's gorgeous. The steering wheel, great quality, leather, great grip, nice design, super futuristic and unique. Even the buttons here, the driving mode, you have here the driving mode, you can change the different driving mode. You have the eco mode, you have the normal mode, you have the sport mode. Depending which mode you are, the car will react accordingly. Also, you have the pedals behind the steering wheel right here to change the regenerative brake. For example, you can see right here on the screen on the left side. I think you have to drive the car. You have three levels. Right now it's level two. Three levels. Then you have another level, one pedal drive. And then you have auto mode when the car will choose for you how to regenerate the energy. So it's just incredible how many options. But all about that, you will find it in the test drive. Click the subscribe button to see the video when we'll come out with a test drive. Also, I like very much this Mercedes Benz style digital cockpit and multimedia system. It's really nice integrated, like the Mercedes have it, and you have such a good visibility from the driver point of view. You have gorgeous visibility, and also even for the passengers, you have a perfect visibility from that angle. I like very much how they integrate this speaker here. It's a speaker, guys. It's just crazy how nice they integrate it here in the dash. Other than that, it's pretty clean and you have a great visibility. Really nice. Even the vents here, the way they integrate it is gorgeous. Also, you can adjust the steering wheel the way you want it, forward, backward, just like that. Manual from down here. As you can see, you have this button driving mode. Perfect, position it right here on the steering wheel. Then you have these controllers right here. It's kind of classic for Hyundai, but this time they put a lot of work and a lot of premium in it. So you can see you have physical button here, different driving mode, voice command, volume, telephone, and save button here, save favorite button. And then you have this nice design right here in the middle. Then on the right side, you can control different views right there. You can see the consumption on the last 82 kilometers, 16.6 kilowatt hour consumption, pretty good consumption, I should say. Last kilometers, 5 kilometers that I drive, also 18. As you can see here, it was 16 as well, but now it's 18. Last 21 kilometers, 16. Pretty good consumption, I should say. Great, great, great consumption. Also here you find this autopilot. As you can see, level 2, it's worked really good. I tested, guys, check out the test drive, you will see there all the infos. I like very much those stalks, they look so unique and so futuristic and such a nice, such a good quality, look at them. Then you have the gear shifter. This time it's here behind the steering wheel. This is the gear shifter, this is the parking button, and then if you want to change the gears, you have to go up or down, just like that. Driving reverse, it's just awesome. I mean, all you have to do is just press the brake, going reverse, for example. Right now we are in reverse, and you can see also the camera. This car come only with the camera, this version, but on the other versions, the full versions, four-wheel drive version, you will have the possibility to have 360 degrees camera. And not only, I will tell you also when that video will come out, I will explain you everything there. The start engine button is right here, guys, look at it, right here. Look how nice it looks, really. The quality is like a Range Rover, I should say. And even the climatic system, you have those touch buttons here, they are lovely. Lovely, guys, they look just so good quality. And then you have also those buttons, you have the volume knob here that feel good, you have the map here, you press the button, you go directly to the map. Is the latest technology, latest multimedia system from Hyundai. You have everything here on this screen, 12 inch screen, they are huge. You have gorgeous visibility, and the graphic, the colors look just incredible nice. Also from here you can control the climatic system, you have also the tune button, then you have also the navigation here, settings, you have also the media button here, then you have the favorite button, you have the camera button right here, you can turn on the camera, the parking sensors, and yeah, wherever. Now what I find out is that the screen, it's incredible responsive. So I mean, look at this, look how responsive it is. I just touch it a little bit, it's crazy responsive. I like very much this screen that tell you how much battery you still have, the range 419 kilometer, and the car, to be honest, is not the bigger battery, but you still have crazy range. Then you go here to the menu, here you have the EV menu where you can see how much kilometer the car can drive. You can see information about the battery, the charging status, you can schedule the charging down here, the EV charging transfer. So you can see, as you know from this car, you can also transfer and send the energy forward to other vehicle. So yeah, you can see the V2L, vehicle to load, automatic discharge down to define. So for example, if you want to give to someone else a battery, you can choose to have, okay, I want to give it, but maximum, I don't want to give it more than 50%, for example. So you can schedule and choose from here. It's just incredible, something unique that not other car, electric car, have it. Now you can also extend here to see the screen, like classic for Hyundai. It's really awesome that you can have here also navigation, or wherever you want to have it, you can have it on the right side, no matter what you have open. Go back to home, then you have the map that you already see. This is the latest map from Hyundai. It's working really fast, it's perfect. I mean, in terms of responsiveness, you have a great processor and power behind these screens. So they put a lot of quality here. The phone projection, voice memo, climatic system, you can control it even from here, guys, how cool is that. Then you have the media, you have the heating system. The car come also with heated steering wheel, heated seats for you and the passenger, and also ventilated seats, if I'm not wrong. I'm not sure if this one have it, but I know the leather one will come. Then valet mode, then settings here. On the settings you have the kind of sound settings, display settings, phone connection. Of course, you have Android Auto, Apple CarPlay, and all that connectivity. Here you have also speed limit, driving convenience, warning timing, warning volume, haptic warning, driver attention warning, forward collision, lane safe, parking safety. Okay, all that settings are here. Driving mode here, eco mode, in climatic mode, brake mode, normal. So you can choose from here, for example, normal or sport, how you like to brake to be. You can control it from here. So you can see on the normal mode, a standard braking response optimized for comfortable daily driving, or sporty, a sportive braking responsive optimized for dynamic driving. So you can choose how the brake to be. So it's crazy how many options you have here. And Hyundai in the last years put a lot of options on their cars. Eco driving, smart recuperation, medium. You can choose from here how the car to recuperate the energy when driving in eco mode, for example, in one pedal drive, for example. Eco driving here, you can see the charging connectors, locking mode. So you can see the charging, how you like to have it always lock while charging. And you can choose from here how you like to have. And then the cluster, the instrument cluster, climatic system, lights. Here you have the lights, and here you have the doors and convenience. So you can choose all that settings how you want to set it. BlueLink, of course, the car come with BlueLink. What you can expect from the latest technology on Hyundai. Then you have the display. The general settings here are about the language, time, date, units, and stuff like that. And then the sound system, guys, you can change from here wherever settings you want. Equalizer, position, driving guidance, radio noise, driver assistant warning, connective device. And yeah, it's crazy complex. I don't want to go too much into detail. I will make another video when the top version will come out. I want to show you really fast today. Quiet mode, you have also the quiet mode, BlueLink, Hyundai Life, manual here. So all those are the most important settings on the car. Then phone projection here, you have the possibility to connect Android Auto and Apple CarPlay via a cable. So keep in mind, you have to use an USB cable if you want to be able to connect those phones. I'm not sure in the future if it will be possible wireless, but yeah, that's it for now. Even here you have a nice graphic on the head-up display, as you can see, gorgeous graphic. And when you're driving, I will show you guys in the test drive, when you're driving, you can see the cars, you can see the car in the front there, you can see those graphics, looks just incredible nice. What can I say, guys? This is kind of a short video about multimedia system. I will also make a full review about the car. I will make another review with the multimedia system when the full version of the car, top version, will come out. And then I will show you all the features, because there will be some kind of features when you turn on the signal. You can see some cameras here. I want to show you everything. But this is something that you can expect when you buy the entry level version. Also up here you have a big mirror, you have some light here, no LEDs, just a normal light, but you have a huge mirror. And also you have here some LED lights, quite fancy, and an SOS button. Lovely seats, I love those seats, I love the pedals, are really really soft and nice. Also I love this space here, lovely car. So overall, guys, I hope you enjoyed the video, I hope it was useful. You want to see the review, you want to see the test drive, you want to see the another videos that I will make it in the future with IONIQ 5, subscribe to the channel, like and share, and I wait you there, guys. Don't forget to subscribe, don't forget to check out our website, and stay safe, and see you soon, guys, in the next one. Bye.